We'll take a look at rationalizing the denominator. All right, as usual, go ahead and pause the video so that you can copy down the notes. So go ahead and pause the video so you can copy down the steps. All right, let's say we had radical 15 over 5 radical 20. Again, this is a single term as a denominator. In other words, there's no addition or subtraction. Break down and simplify as possible. So let's break down that radical 20 and the 15. So the 15 is going to be 3 times 5. The radical 20 is going to be 4 times 5. And 4 is going to break down to 2 times 2. Just go ahead and rewrite it in there. So 5 radical and then 2 twos and a 5. Like two different ways. So we can take out a book. So there's going to be a book of twos outside. Just like that. And then remember, if it's on the top and on the bottom, you can also cancel it out. So it's going to cancel that 5 and that 5. So what do we have left? Radical 3 on the top. And then we have on the outside, we have 2 times 5, which is 10. So it's really going to be radical 3 over 10. So there are two ways to simplify. You can take out books and you can cancel what's on the top if it's also on the bottom. Let's take a look at another example. So I'm going to zoom through these examples pretty quick because it's easy as a single term. So let's say we had radical 2 over 2 radical 3. We can't break that down, but you're supposed to break it down. There's nothing to break down. So then multiply top and bottom by the denominator. So we're going to multiply top and bottom by the denominator. So multiply top by 2 radical 3, bottom by 2 radical 3. Then it's just like multiplying radicals. Remember, there's an invisible 1 outside that radical 2. So 1 times 2 is 2. And then inside we have 2 times 3. Then we have 2 times 2 is 4. Then inside we have 3 times 3. Well, I have a book. So better to take the book out than cancel, because if you cancel, you'll have to rationalize the denominator again. So it's going to be radical 2 radical 6 and then 4 times 3 outside. So that's going to be 2 radical 6 over 4 times 3, which is 12. Then cancel top and bottom, remember. 2 goes into 2 one time and into 12 six times. So it's just simplifying fractions and radicals in the same problem. All right, let's take a look at one more example. Let's say we had, let's make it a little more complicated. Say we had that. All right, again, first thing is to break down and simplify if possible. So I'm just going to break everything down. That's on the top, I'm going to have a radical, then 3, then 2x's, 3y's. On the bottom, I'm going to have 4 radical, 5, 1x, and 3y's. And again, remember, let me cancel top and bottom so that it has less things to worry about. So if it's on the top, it cancels on the bottom. On the top, it cancels on the bottom. So now let's rewrite this. Let's see what we have left. So we have radical 3x over 4 radical 5. Now let's rationalize the denominator by multiplying top and bottom by the denominator. So right now the denominator is 4 radical 5. So we're going to do that top and bottom. And then go ahead and multiply. So there's an invisible 1 by that. There you go. That's 1 times 4 is 4. And then inside you have a 3, 5, and x. Then outside 4 times 4 is 16. And then inside you have 2 5s. You have a book. So I'd rather take the book out so that I don't have to deal with radicals. So I'm going to have 4 radical 15x over 16 times 5. Break down the 16 on the bottom to 4 times 4. So then now you're going to have 4 radical 15x over 4 times 4 times 5. Again, if it's on the top and the bottom, you can go ahead and cross it out. So cross out the 4 on the top, the 4 on the bottom. Then look at what you have left. You have radical 15x over 4 times 5, which is 20. This is a listening check. Go ahead and color in that answer. Radical 15x over 20. So what if the denominator wasn't just a single term? Then if you have an additional subtraction as a denominator. So pause the video real quick. Copy those notes down. All right, so let's take a look at an example. So let's say we had negative 4 over 6 plus radical 3. The idea is pretty much the same. However, there's one little difference. So there's an addition and subtraction sign at the bottom. Put parentheses around all addition and parentheses. There we go. Multiply top and bottom denominator, only change whatever the sign is. So that's plus, it becomes minus. So change the sign. So you're multiplying the top and bottom by the same thing, only changing the sign. It's going to be 6 minus radical 3. 6 minus radical 3. And then multiply as normal, simplify. So let's get in the house, or go ahead and put parentheses actually. So put negative 4 in the house. So negative 4 in the house is going to give you negative 24. And then negative times a negative is a positive, so that's going to give me positive 4 radical 3 over Now make sure each person says hi. So 6 times 6 is 36. Says hi to the next person, negative 6 radical 3. This guy says hi, that's going to be 6 plus 6 radical 3. And then last person says hi, it's going to be a house and you're going to have 3 and 3 inside. Well, now what can I do now? I've got a book on that very last term, so I can take that out. Also, negative 6 radical 3 plus 6 radical 3 is 0 radical 3. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to have negative 24 plus 4 radical 3 over 36 and the book you just had outside, so minus 3. All right, go ahead and combine those denominators for me. So you're going to get negative 24 plus 4 radical 3 over 33. So simplify. So put parentheses and see if you can take out anything. I can take out a 4 actually, but it's not going to cancel with that 33, so I can just leave it. But I'm going to do an example on this next one where you're going to see that it's going to cancel when I take it out. This is a listening check. Shade in the 0 in that 10. Shade in the 0 in that 10 only. So again, the very first thing you're going to do is put parentheses around any addition subtraction. Then you're going to multiply top and bottom by the same thing, only change the sign. So this one is addition, so we're going to go from addition to subtraction. So from addition, we're going to do subtraction. So the exact same thing, only change the sign in the middle. All right, then get in the house. So that's going to be 80, 10 times 8, and then negative 10 radical 10. Then on the bottom, make sure you say hi to everyone, 8 times 8, 64. 8 times radical 10 is negative 8 radical 10. That's going to be 8 radical 10. And the last one is going to be radical and then inside 10 times 10. All right, so again, we're going to simplify. So just simplify. On the bottom, this is going to cancel because negative 8 plus 8 is going to give me 0. We didn't take a book out, so we're going to write this out. So it's going to be 80 minus 10 radical 10. And then on the bottom, it's going to be 64 minus the book you just took out, 10. Again, keep simplifying so we can combine the bottom. So 80 minus 10 radical 10, and on the bottom 64 minus 10, which is 54. Now remember, you put parentheses, factor, and see if you can simplify again. I can take out 2, and the reason I'm going to take it out is because I can see it's going to cancel with that 54. So take out 2, what's going to be left? 40 minus 5, and then over 54. Take out 2 from 54, I get 27. Now the reason again is, again, I can see top and bottom as a 2, so I can cancel. Anything else I can take out there, I can take out 5, but it's not going to cross out that 27, so I'm just going to leave it like that. So that's why it's very important at the end to factor and simplify. Alright, number 3, copy that down. So again, we're going to change, we put parentheses, we're going to change it from, what is it, subtraction, so we're going to change it to addition. So it's going to change from subtraction to addition, the exact same thing, top and bottom, but now it's addition, just like that. After that, we're going to get in the house. Negative radical 10 times 3 is 3, negative 3 radical 10. Negative radical 10 times 3 is negative, and then 3 and 10 inside the house. That times that is 9, then say hi, 3 radical 3, then 3 minus 3 radical 3, then negative, and then 3 times 3 in the book. So again, looking at the bottom after we simplify, those two are going to cancel. And then we're going to take a book out. So we're going to simplify, the top stays the same. And the bottom is going to have 9 minus 3. All right, then 9 minus 3 is what? 6. Then again, is there anything I can take out? No, there's nothing I can take out, so I'm done. All right, so this is a shortcut. The denominator will always be the difference of squares. If you understand what that means, you can do this a lot faster. But if you don't understand what that means, then I'm just not going to go into it. And that's it. So let's practice.